taking up another system of ASCARIS, which is the reproductive system. So students, as we have discussed in the earlier lectures, that all the systems of the ASCARIS, they are quite easy and they are quite simple in form and structure. So the reproductive system is also quite simple in case of ASCARIS. Now, first thing to mention over here is that the sexes in the ASCARIS, they are separate. So that means we have got male and female ASCARIS altogether different. So they are showing a particular phenomenon which is called as the sexual dimorphism. Sexual dimorphism means that males and females, they are altogether different in their morphologies. So one can separate them out by just seeing them, that this is a male and this is a female. So that process or the phenomenon is called as sexual dimorphism. In the previous lectures, we have discussed about the morphology of male and female. So males were shorter than the females, and those males were curved from the hind end. So that was the difference in the morphology. And if we take up the gonads of these animals or ASCARIS, so these are typically long, they are coiled, and they are tubular in nature. So if you see the gonads of the male and the female, both are typically coiled and tubular. So we'll be taking up the male and the female reproductive systems one by one. So first of all, we are starting with the male reproductive system. So if we talk about the male reproductive system, it is again quite simple. So we have got testes, and we have a single testis over here, and this kind of condition is called as the monarchic kind of condition. So here we have a single testis, we don't write it as testes. So that was the case of the male reproductive system. Then we have the vas deferens, the seminal vesicles, and the ejaculatory duct. So this is a quite simple kind of male reproductive system. So if you see the diagram of this particular system, so it is just like this. So this is the diagram of male reproductive system. So students, it starts with the testes. So we are writing on the very left as the parts of this reproductive system. So here we have the testes. So that means this is a single testis, and this is present over here. So this particular testis is single, the condition is monarchic, and it extends to the middle of the body. So you can very well see that the testis, it is extending up till the middle of the body. So it is quite long in structure, it is thread-like, and it is highly twisted kind of tube. So the testes, it is responsible for the formation of the sperms, though the germinal epithelium, which is present inside the lining of this testis lumen, it is producing the sperms. So these sperms are found in clusters of amoeboid shape. So these are amoeboid shaped sperms which are produced in the testes of the ASCARIS. So as such, there is no lumen in the case of testes, but the sperms which are formed inside this particular structure, they are pulled, or they are, you can say, taken along the tube into the next part, which is called as the vas deferens. So we have got the second part, it is vas deferens. So it is a tube-like structure again. So this is the vas deferens, which is the second part, and it is taking the sperms, it is carrying the sperms to the next part of the reproductive system, which is the seminal vesicle. So students, you know that the seminal vesicle is responsible for storing of the sperms. So that means the sperms which are coming out of the testes through the vas deferens, they are stored in the seminal vesicle, and whenever required they are ejaculated through the next part, which is the ejaculatory duct. So this is the fourth part. System. So here you can very well see that this is the ejaculatory duct. So the sperms, they will be ejaculated out of this male ascaris through the cloacal aperture. Now I am concerned now about this part of the body of ascaris, which is carrying the cloaca and the pineal setae. So in the next diagram, we'll be seeing this part of the body. This is the diagram which is showing the posterior part of the male ascaris. Now students, here you can very well see this is the ejaculatory duct from which the sperms are coming towards the lower side from the seminal vesicle. Now here is the cloaca. So this is the cloacal aperture, which is a combination of two tubes. Now this is very, very important to note that the first tube that is opening into this cloaca is the rectum, or this is the outpour of the digestive tract. And the second thing which is opening into cloaca is the ejaculatory duct, and this is a part of the reproductive system. So as we have discussed earlier, that the cloaca is a combination of these two systems, that digestive or the alimentary canal and the reproductive system or the ejaculatory duct, they are both opening at this particular structure which is called as the cloaca. So this cloaca is present only in the male. It is not present in the female. In the female, we have got a particular anus, and the ejaculatory duct, or you can say the genital pore, is present as the female genital pore over there, or we write it as gonopore in case of female ascaris. We were talking about the ejaculatory duct, and now this is a very important point, that the ejaculatory duct, it contains a number of prostatic glands. So in this part, we have the prostatic glands. So these prostatic glands, they are also producing the prostatic fluid. So the prostatic fluid, it helps in the copulation process. So the sperms, they are traveling down through the ejaculatory duct. The prostatic fluid, it is mixed into those sperms, and the semen are formed, and this semen, it will be leaving the cloaca. Now students, after this we have another structure, we call it as, these are the pineal setae, and these are two in number, and they are present in the cloacal sac or the pineal sac. So as you can very well see, this is the pineal sac, and this is the pineal seta or spicule. So here it has been demarcated as a single pineal seta, but these are two in number in male ascaris. Now apart from this pineal sac or seta, we have got two types of muscles which are involved in the movement of this pineal seta. So the first muscles first type of muscles are the spicule protractors. So these protractors, they are protruding out the pineal seta while it is copulating. So what is the function of these pineal setae? It is to grab, or it is to cling down to the female whenever the copulation occurs. So these muscles, the spicule protractors, they are protruding out the pineal seta. The second type of muscles in the pineal sac are the spicule retractors. So what happens when these retractors, they contract, the pineal seta will move inwards towards the sac. It will come in the sac, and whenever the spicule protractors, they contract and they tend to move the pineal seta towards outside. So these are the two types of muscles in the pineal sac, and this is the whole diagram of the hind end showing the cloacal aperture, the pineal sac, and the pineal setae. So with this, we finish with the male reproductive system of Ascaris. So if we take into account the whole system, we have got single testes. It is very tube-like structure. You can very well see, you have seen it in the previous diagram. Then we have a vas deferens. This is again a tube which is carrying the sperms to the next part, which is the seminal vesicle. So this is a bag-like, long bag-like structure, which is storing the sperms. And this seminal vesicle is, you can say, it is going out towards the cloaca as a duct, which is the ejaculatory duct. And this duct has got the prostate glands, and this is opening out at the cloacal aperture. So at the aperture, we have got the pineal sac, in which we have got two pineal setae, and we have got the protractors and the retractor muscles present over there. So that was the male reproductive system. So now, students, we are heading towards the next part, which is the female reproductive system of Ascaris. This system is comprised of, again, a very simple kind of structures. First are the ovaries. So I am talking about ovaries, not ovary. So that means we have got two ovaries over here. We have got oviducts, we have got the uteri, two uteri, and we have got the vaginal tube. So these four things are making up the female reproductive system. So first of all, the posterior side of the female, it is quite straight. It is not comparable to male, as it was curved in case of the male. And here we have a very simple, straight posterior side of the female Ascaris. Now, if we talk about the very first part of the female reproductive system, so first of all, we have to go with the diagram. We should go with the diagram first of all. So if we see this diagram, you can very well see the presence of ovaries. Now here, one thing I want to mention, that we can start it on the other side. So we can start with suppose we are starting with the vaginal tube. So this is the very first part of the female reproductive system over here. So here you can very well see the presence of the vaginal tube, which is opening out as the female gonopore, and it is opening behind the mouth. So this is the mouth, and it is present behind the mouth near to the middle of the body. So this is the female gonopore, into which this vaginal tube, it goes down. Now again, we have the next part. This tube is going into two uteri. So uterus is a single, you can say, word, and uteri is a plural of uterus. So we got two uteri over here. So you can very well see this particular structure is the uterus. So one is on this side, one is on the left side. So we got two uteri. Now this uterus, it is containing the capsules or the fertilized eggs. So what is the physiology? We'll be taking up in the later lectures. So if we take the third part after the uteri, the second was the uteri. If I take the third thing, it is the oviduct. Now oviduct is present over here. This is the oviduct, and you can very well see the fourth part, which is after the oviduct, it is the ovary, or here we should write as ovaries, because these are two in number. Now, why I have taken a reverse kind of approach in this particular system is, it is due to a fact that the oviducts and the ovaries, they are coiled over the uterus. So if I remove this arrow, here you can very well see that the ovaries and the oviducts, they are coiled over the uterus, and this ovary and oviduct, they are uncoiled. So in a, if you cut one female ASCARIS, you will find the ovary and the oviducts in this particular position. So that's why we have taken it in a reverse side. So if you start with the ovary, it is coiled over the uterus. If you take the oviduct, it is coiled over the uterus. And then we have this third part of the female reproductive tract. And then we have the fourth part. It is the vaginal tube, which is opening out as the gonopore. So students, that were the four parts of the female reproductive system in ASCARIS. Now students, after the male and the female reproductive systems, now we have the next part, which is the gamete formation. Now in ASCARIS, the gametogonia, they are budded off from the proximal end of the gonads. So as we have discussed that there is no lumen in case of the testes. So here the gametogonia, they are budded off from the end of the gonads, and they undergo a process which is called as gametogenesis. So many of the books, they have written three stages in the gamete formation. So I'll be taking these three very briefly. So if I take the very first kind of the process in the gamete formation, this is the germinal zone. Now, this is also called as the proliferation zone. And this zone is lying at the proximal blind end of the gonad. Now, this is a part of the gonad, which is the germinal zone. Now, usually, it is a single large terminal cell which is constituting this particular zone. So, this apical cell, which is in fact the epithelial cell of a gonad, it lies in the front of the terminal cell from which the gametogonia arise by budding. So you can see that this particular germinal zone is present in the gonad. This is present at the proximal part, and this is giving rise to one, the gametogonium. Now the second zone of you can say the reproductive tract is the, this is the growth zone. this zone, it follows the first germinal zone. Now here what happens, the gametogonia which lie attached to the cytoplasmic rachis, they grow in size. So here, because it is the growth zone, the gametogonia which are formed in the germinal zone, they grow in size. And when they grow, they differentiate into amoeboid gametocytes. So here what we have is that the gametogonia, they are differentiating it, they are going for the formation of gametocytes. So this is happening in the growth zone. So in the germinal zone, we had, that was the formation of the gametogonia. So in the growth zone, those gametogonia, they grow in size and they are differentiated into the gametocytes. Now students, we have got the third kind of a zone, which is the maturation zone. This maturation zone, it is at the very distal end of, you can say, the gonads. So here the gametocytes in this particular zone, the gametocytes which are formed in the growth zone, they separate from this particular thing and they undergo maturation. So they undergo maturation. So after undergoing this maturation process, now what happens? They form the gametes. So this is how the gametes are formed. And the gametes which are formed in after the maturation zone, they are taken up into the tubes. So either this tube can be the vas deferens in case of males, and it can be the oviduct in the case of females. So this is the process of the formation of the gametes in a gonad. So we have the first zone as the germinal zone, in which the gametogonia were formed. The growth zone, in which the gametogonia, they become large in size, they grow in size and they differentiate into the gametocytes. Now in the maturation zone, the gametocytes, they go for maturation and they form gametes. So this is how the gametes are formed in the ASCARIS. Now after the gamete formation, we have got two types of gametes formed. We have got sperms and we have got ova. So here one thing should be mentioned, that the sperms, they are amoeboid in shape, whereas the ova, they are somewhat elliptical in shape. So these are the shapes of the gametes which are present in the ASCARIS. So ova at this particular stage are actually the secondary oocytes. So they have resulted from the oogonia, which is very comparable to the gametogonia. And this happens by a single maturation division. So the second maturation division occurs while the fertilization happens. So that is after the fertilization. So up till here, the gametes or the ova, especially ova, these are with the single maturation division. So students, after this, we are starting with the life history of the ASCARIS in the next lecture. So thanks for now.